hardening of the Thanksgiving turkeys, which we saw today, too. So we're in the period of, I think it's hilarious that the president consistently does this. And seems to relish the moment.
He enjoys it. It's clear. That
father
he has
of
the
two
time
young kids? How could you not?
Well, let me say this. Let me say this.
He also enjoys embarrassing his daughter.
I would say one thing that's going to make me very unpopular. I think it's unfortunate that the president's daughters didn't come to this final one. And I know that they're teenagers. And look, my kids are 9, and they don't think I'm funny. I'm sure they do not think it's funny anymore, and they don't want to be there. But
they did 7. You're not going to let them off, John, for number 8?
I think it would have been nice. I think it would have been nice one last time.
You know, they're sticking around D.C., so at least he's got that.
I do think it's nice that he had his nephews there. I thought that was a nice kind of, place.
Now, what I saw is a president that says, you know what, boys, I'm on the way out. And it's been good, and it's been a good run, but I'm on the way out.
And their names were Tater and Tot. And Tot.
Yeah.
Tater and Tot. Jeffrey Lord, can you tell us who the first president to pardon a turkey was?
I believe it was Abraham Lincoln.
Yes. Yes, you're right, Jeffrey. Thank you. Thank you for getting that right.
You know, the internet's going to make a lot of jokes about this. I'm not going to make any of them, but depending on what side of the political aisle you're on, they're going to make a lot of jokes about
turkeys
have been pardoned and could be pardoned.
I will tell you this. The best joke on Twitter was someone who tweeted me that said, Tater is going to be pardoned, but Tot actually won the popular vote.
Exactly.
Oh, wow.
Well, let's be noted, for Thanksgiving, we got through an entire show, and Jeffrey didn't say Ronald Reagan one time.
That's right. Well, but he did have the world's
Ronald
largest
Reagan.
Picture of Ronald Reagan.
Let me ask one serious question, because we were talking about the president and his popularity. It's up at, 54% in our last poll, or maybe even higher in the last poll now. And he continues to talk about it, but it just doesn't translate or didn't translate. So he leaves as a popular president, but he also leaves the Democratic Party in Shamblesville.
Yeah, that's exactly right. I mean, so in 2008, he won this historic election, and he anticipated that in 2010 he would be able to translate that support into change in Congress. That is not what happened. They were decimated in 2010. 2012, he won. 2014, they were decimated again, not only in Congress, but at the state level. And so, yes, he is leaving very popular. There are a lot of reasons for that. It clearly didn't help Hillary Clinton much. It didn't help them much in Senate races as well. It's a big question mark, and that's really what the Democratic Party is hoping to sit down to Thanksgiving dinner. Yes, Hillary Clinton won, everything else is a mess, but now they've got nothing. And Barack Obama, he never found a way to translate the personal likability into electoral.
And this is why they will all be watching football tomorrow instead of talking politics. Guys, thank you all for being with us. Have a happy and peaceful Thanksgiving. I mean it.
Happy Thanksgiving.
Thank you.
Life at Trump.